After you have joined a VoiceThread group, click on the Home button in the top left corner of the page. From here, click on the sidebar icon on the left to view all of your groups. Click on the title of the group that you'd like to view, and then close the sidebar by clicking on the arrow again. This shows you all of the VoiceThreads that have been shared with this group. Click on any one thumbnail to open that VoiceThread and listen to the comments and record some of your own. When you're ready to contribute a VoiceThread of your own to the group, click Add Your Own in the top right corner, and you can create a new VoiceThread or select from those that you have already created. In this case, let's create a new VoiceThread. We will upload some media, give the VoiceThread a title, and save. Your second step is to record some comments on the VoiceThread. This is a good place to introduce your VoiceThread and invite discussion. When you're done, click on the X in the top right corner. Your last step is to share the VoiceThread. Now don't worry if you forget this step, we'll remind you before you leave the page. When you're ready, click on Share, and then click on the button to share with your group. Once you're done, you can continue to edit the VoiceThread, or you can return to the group, which is where you started. Here you'll see your new VoiceThread shared with the group. An alternative way to share a VoiceThread with a group is to simply come to your homepage, grab the VoiceThread thumbnail, and drag it into the group on the left. Just confirm by clicking Share, and you're done. The last way to share a VoiceThread with a group is to hover your mouse over one you've created and click on the Share button. Click on the name of your group on the left, make sure that the correct level of permission is selected on the right, decide whether or not to notify your members by email, and then click Share. Any one of these three sharing methods will allow you to share a VoiceThread of your own with a group.